Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. So today we're on this KA. I'm gonna start taking the front end off and get all that exposed so we can see the damage. I've got a funny idea what the damage is, but yeah, because I've just sort of looked under the bumper and stuff and sort of pulled the pits. But we'll have a look at that anyway. The other vehicles, I'm waiting for parts. The red Fiesta fitted the bumpers. They've gone back over to the paint shop just so that he wants to make sure that the colour matches, you know, the way we need it to match. So that's good. The Focus is still there. We're still waiting on parts for the Focus. We're waiting on the rad pack to turn up, and the underneath bar as well, support bar. I've got a new one of those coming as well. So I'm just waiting for a few parts on that before we can carry on doing that one. So that's kind of on the back burner for the minute. But yeah, for today, we're gonna jump in here. I think I've sourced most of the parts for this car. I found the bonnet, I found the rad pack, I found the wing, because that's damaged, that's gotta be replaced. Driver's wing's gotta be changed. So I found one of them. I have got a light up, just up there. I don't know if you can see it. It's up on top of there. So I've got a light, and that is the passenger side, because both these lights, they're damaged. They're beyond repair. They're beyond savable. They've got to be thrown and changed, unfortunately. But yeah, so I've got the passenger one up there we can put in and do a lug repair on that one, I think. I've just got to check it. And then the driver's one, I've got a source, which is, you know, 50 quid or whatever it is. We'll jump in this in a second. We'll jump into this and start ripping it apart. But before I do, guys, thanks. You know, I really appreciate all the support, all the comments. I always try and get back to everyone that comments on the channel and any of my videos. I always try and get back to you. I really appreciate it, guys. I had a couple of people saying that, about the fees and the prices of Copart at a minute. They are high. Copart prices are high. But for some reason, the fees, I think, the actual fees have gone down for some reason. I don't know what's going on. But it used to cost me like £400 with all the fees and everything included, VAT, the lot. But now I'm only paying like 200 quid. For all the fees. It's really weird. So the hammer price plus 200 quid is what I'm paying. Like this one here, like this only cost me 500 quid. I don't know. I'll have to go back and look for all my invoices from last year and all that sort of stuff. But I don't know what it is, but I can't see it being the more I'm buying, the less I'm paying in fees. That's not, I don't think that's the case. It's just, I just don't know what it is, but it is what it is. You just got to roll with it. You just got to go with the times. There's no point sort of saying, Copart are expensive now, so you know, oh, that's the end of it. No, you have to move, and you have to adjust with what's going on, and that's what I'm doing. Like, I'm only picking cars that I know are right price. They're not overpriced. I think the one of the Coursers was overpriced, and I'm never going to get a Vauxhall Courser again because that was ridiculous. But didn't lose money, but it was just, yeah, it wasn't enough profit in it really to warrant doing the Vauxhall Coursers anymore. So I won't be doing those anymore, guys. I'll stop blabbering on, guys. I'm just going to crack on with this car. So I'll set you up. We'll get this front end off, and then we'll actually have a real true look at the damage behind the bumper. We'll go from there. I'll set you up, guys. So there we go. That didn't take too long. Just a bumper, a few bolts. Excuse me. Sorry, guys, just had a drink. Cheers. Let's take out the damage. Right. So let's look at the sides first. So as you can see from that, let me come out a little bit, that's it. So you can see that it's just whacked over at the top, like it's just been like sort of donked. So that top needs to be sort of obviously straight like that. Do you see what I'm saying? But the leg itself hasn't been damaged. I just had a quick look. So that they're not being touched, both sides. But it's probably been kinked over at the top on that bracket. I'll have to get behind and take that off. So we'll do that next. We'll take these bars off and we'll have a look at that. But yeah, you can see that it's had a little bit of a tweak at the top there. But these crash bars have just not been touched. Obviously, that crash bar is a little bit wonky at the top there, which is easily be able to bend that back. So I'm not really concerned about that at all, really. Should be all right. Bottom one hasn't been touched at all. The bar itself has been, absolutely fine. It's just obviously that as it comes out, and then it's just been, it's obviously been hit there, isn't it? It's been hit there. It's had a whack. The bonnet's had a whack. And it's completely missed this crash bar here. So I don't know if that's the impact, because you can see that this is cracked straight through. So was the impact there? Not quite sure. Who knows? But let's have a look at the other leg. This one ain't as bad. You can see that if I come out a little bit like that, it's not as bad. It's got that little kink slightly, but not as bad as the other side. So possibly the other side was where the impact was, because you can see the brackets. This one here is kinked less than the other side. The other side's really kicking up. So possibly, but in saying that, the wing's damaged here, but I don't know. I'm just guessing, isn't I? So, but yeah, so definitely the rad pattern is changing. The slam, like the front panel, that's all going to need changing. Take the crash bars off. We'll put them aside. And yeah, I'll keep going for now, and then I'll keep coming back in and out, and we'll see how we're going. Yeah. Right, okay, so I've took the bars off, as you can see they're over there, but I've had to stop for a minute because I thought, because of all this damage, there's no way there's going to be gas in there, but typical, there is. So I've got to get it out of the system, and how we do that is we plug this machine in and we pull all the gases out of the system in the cars, and yeah, so we can get the disconnect the rads and get it all off. So I'm gonna hook it up, and then we're gonna suck it all out, get it out of the system, and then we can carry on removing the rad pack condenser. Yeah, so I'll plug it in. I had to stop because it just it is pressurized, and I thought there's no way there's gonna be any in this, but there was. So I'll. I'll come back to you in a sec, guys. Well, I'll set you up so you can see what's going on, and we'll go from there. Okay, guys, there we go. That didn't take long. Took the wing off as well. So that's all off there. This little putty stuff was like stuck to the side of the wing. So I'm gonna have to maybe use some Tiger Seal. Put up there, stick it on. I don't know, I'm gonna try and, you know, keep it as original as I could. So I'm gonna use probably some Tiger Seal. That will stick it on there like that, be fine. So, here we go. It's all off. Don't look like no other damage, to be honest with you. It just looks like this little leg here has got a little tweak at the top here. So that's, yep. Get some Stilsons or something on that and just bring it back in line. And that's it. That's the only little bit of damage that I need to repair. And then we could just put it back on. I have sourced a few bits and pieces for this car now, so I might just shoot over there and just see what he's got and bring back whatever I can. And then, yeah, just go ahead and start literally rebuilding it. So, there we go. I'm gonna leave it there for the minute. I'm gonna shoot over to him, go and get some bits, come back, I'll show you what I've got. I'll see you soon. So, I'm back from the old breakers, see what I've got. So first of all, yep, got ourselves a bonnet in colour. There's a couple of little scratches on it, but nothing too deep. And, you know, we can deal with it when it comes to using the buffer. So I'll put it on and then, yeah, check it all out and buff up the whole thing. But yeah, it's all good. It's all good. It's all there. No dents, no donks on it, so that's good. And it's in colour, so absolute result with that. So that's that. Got that. What else did we get? Got this light. Got the headlight, and we've got the brackets for the bonnet as well. You can see them. I don't know about the brackets when it comes to the bonnet. When it's had a little bit of a whack like that, you never know whether or not, you know, it's had a little kink here, or it's had a little kink there or there. You just don't know with these hinges. So it's not even worth trying to deal with the original ones. It's just change them. Just change them, peace of mind, you know that it's done, and you know there's no sort of, there's gonna be no issues when fitting the other bonnet. So yeah, there we go. So yeah, headlight, hinges, rad pack complete. With slam panel, everything comes with the bars as well. I had no sort of choice really, so I thought, okay, let's just, you know, fit it as a whole unit, and then there's no problems, and I can use those other bars somewhere else, or you know, for spares later on or whatever. So yeah, and it comes with the side wings as well to fit on each side to the thing. But the other good thing about this one particularly is it's got a brand new radiator and fan. So, yeah, absolute result with that. Really, really lucky finding one with in this kind of condition as well. So, yeah, really chuffed for that, guys. So that's that. Obviously, the aircon air conditioner, you know, it's the same original one, but the rad is new. So yeah, happy dice, a bit of bonus. Obviously got the wing here, and again got it in color, and as yeah, absolute result. So what, really happy with that. This there's the old one all kinked up and stuff, and yeah, really, really happy with it because it's in color as well. So absolute result. So there we go. So I've got, yeah, so I've got the wing, the slam panel, the brackets, the headlight, and the bonnet, and all of this, all of these parts, come to 220 quid, which I thought, you know, wasn't a bad price considering, really. So, yeah, the other thing as well, we agreed on that price, and then I just sort of, you know, right at the end when I was just giving them the money and we were setting up and stuff, I said to him, "Don't suppose you've got a starter motor kicking about anywhere, have you?" And he went, "Yeah, might have." I said, "Well, you know, could you throw that in for just to seal the deal. You know, could throw it in for free. And yeah, he did. So got ourselves a starter motor for free. I know it's not a new one, and you know, but if it works all right, then result, happy days. And it's for free, so nothing to lose, all to gain. So yeah, absolute result, guys. So
there we go.
So all we've got to do now is start fitting it up and start fitting them back on. I think what I'm going to try and do first is obviously do the starter motor, because that's right underneath at the back. It's just easier laying closer to the engine underneath. So I'll replace that, and then start on the front and start putting it back together. So, but for now, that is going to be it on this video. And then on the next video, we're going to be sort of putting it all together and see how far we get with it. But it's coming along really quickly, really. All I've got to do now, really, is get the bumper. I'm trying to find it in colour, but at the moment I can't find it in colour. So, yeah, I'm going to have to sort of keep searching for that and keep working out what I'm going to do. But, yeah, absolute, really, really going quick at the moment on this one. So, yeah, as I said, guys, that's going to be it for today's video. Appreciate all the support. Don't forget to give the videos a thumbs up. Really do appreciate it. Drop me a comment if you've got anything to say. And I'll see you on the next one, guys.